Lindsay Ann. Welcome back to Pie Week, where every day this week I'm gonna be sharing a new pie video, from the best ever pie crust to my favorite pie flavors to totally show-stopping decorations. Today we're doing a classic and we're dressing it up in this gorgeous pie crust rose lattice top designs. So let's get into it with the best apple pie. I couldn't do Pie Week without doing the queen of pies. Apple pie is probably the most all-American dessert out there. You can have it year round. It's perfect for Thanksgiving or Christmas. You can have it in the summertime for picnics. Basically, if there's one pie recipe you've got to learn how to make, this apple pie should be at the top of your list. And if you're not already subscribed to my YouTube channel, be sure to tap that subscribe button to be the first to see my all new videos. This tender, buttery, flaky pie crust is filled with fresh, juicy apples smothered in a warm, gooey, caramely filling. And oh my gosh, add a scoop of vanilla ice cream and serve this a la mode for the most incredible dessert ever. So we start with the pie crust, and as always, I'll leave the full written recipe for you guys down below, or you can get it at lindsayannbakes.com. I made my favorite super simple buttery pie crust to kick off Pie Week because you can do it in advance and then just pop it in the fridge or freezer until you're ready to make your pie. But you can definitely use a store-bought version too if you want a simple alternative. The homemade version is just so buttery and flaky and delicious, you guys, so be sure to check that video out too if you want to make the entire pie from scratch. So for the lattice top, just roll out your dough about a quarter inch thick. Then using a ruler and a knife, just go ahead and slice 12 half-inch strips of pie dough. Then just go ahead and set these aside for our lattice top later, and with your second pie crust, just go ahead and press it right into the bottom and up the sides of a 9-inch pie dish. And then just go ahead and trim the dough all around the edge. So for the beautiful pie crust roses, just go ahead and roll out your dough about 1/8 inch thick. Then use a 2-inch circle cutter to cut out 5 circles. Overlap the 5 circles on top of each other and flatten them out around the edges and smush them together. And by making the edges of the circles nice and paper thin, that's what's going to create that realistic looking rose. Then you're going to roll them up all together and slice it right in half widthwise. And this is going to create 2 roses. Then just go ahead and spread out the petals of the rose to create that beautiful realistic looking rose shape. And just repeat this process to make as many roses as you want. I did a cluster of 5 roses on one side, and then I added the 6th rose to the other side of the pie. So that's a total of 15 circles to create the 6 roses. Then just go ahead and use a little leaf cutter to cut out some leaves. And I did these in 2 different sizes. I did some big leaves and some small leaves to arrange around the pie crust. Then go ahead and just pop the roses and the leaves in the freezer while we prepare the rest of the decorations and the pie filling so they have a chance to really firm up and hold their shape. Okay, now we can get started on the filling, and here's where my secret ingredient comes in that sets this apple pie apart from any other apple pie you've ever had. Instead of just melting the butter, we're gonna take it one step further and brown the butter, and it creates this like caramely toffee-like flavor that is just like pure liquid gold in this apple pie filling. So just core, peel, and slice your apples into 1/4-inch slices. And just place all your apple slices in a bowl and set those aside. And I always use green Granny Smith apples when I'm making my apple pie, not because they're my favorite eating apple, which they are, but because they keep that nice, tart, juicy flavor even after baking. Some apples tend to get a little too mushy or they're too sweet, so when you get that nice brown sugar caramel filling on top of the crisp, juicy, tart green apples, it's like the perfect combination for apple pie. Then in a small saucepan, we're just gonna go ahead and melt our butter over medium heat, whisking constantly until the butter eventually bubbles up. And then it's gonna start foaming and eventually turn a light brown color, giving off this amazing nutty aroma. And this is how you make brown butter. Just make sure to keep stirring it so it doesn't burn. You just want that lightly brown golden color, about 5 to 10 minutes. Then go ahead and stir in the flour and cook it for about 1 minute to remove any lumps. Then to thicken this pie up, we're just gonna dissolve some cornstarch into some apple cider or apple juice. And then go ahead and just stir this right into the butter mixture. Then we add some white sugar, brown sugar, cinnamon, nutmeg, and salt. And then just stir this all in there, and we're gonna bring this to a boil and cook it for about 1 minute until it's nice and thick. Then we're gonna go ahead and reduce the heat and add in some vanilla extract for flavor, and in go our apple slices. And I like to partially cook the apples down in the pot for a few minutes before we bake it. This just lets the apples release some of their juices in the pot and starts to soften a little bit. And we're just gonna simmer this for about 3 to 5 minutes until the apples have softened slightly. And this is a really important step. Instead of just pouring the fresh apples into the pie crust and baking it, once the apples cook, they shrink a little bit. So some apple pies, you're gonna get that huge gap between the pie crust and the pie filling from the apples shrinking. So by pre-cooking this, we totally eliminate that altogether. And also the filling gets nice and thick before we bake it. So when you slice into it, you don't get that like soupy, runny filling. You get that nice, thick, caramely, gooey filling that is like my favorite part. And that's our apple pie filling. So before we pop this in our pie dish to bake, we just wanna bring it to room temperature first. And if you're making this in advance, just go ahead and cover it up and pop it in the fridge. It'll be good for a few days so you can do everything in advance and then put it all together. All right, so once our filling is cooled, we're just gonna go ahead and pour it into our prepared pie crust. And then we get to decorate. So we're gonna add our lattice top to this. So just go ahead and lay 6 of the pie strips right across the top. And then one by one, you're gonna lay the other 6 across in the opposite direction, going under, over in a kind of basket weaving pattern. And that's your basic lattice pie top. I wanted to do a kind of diamond shape, so I went ahead and took one row of the strips and kind of adjusted them to create more of a diamond shape. Then we're gonna go ahead and use some egg wash to adhere our leaves right to the top of our pie crust. And just use a pastry brush to brush the egg wash in the places where you want to attach all the roses and leaves to decorate your pie. I went ahead and did a cluster of 5 roses on one side and just add some leaves all around them to decorate. And then I used the 6 rows to use on the other side to add a little contrast. Then just go ahead and brush the entire top of the crust and all the decorations with egg wash to give it that nice golden brown flaky layer on top. All right, now we're gonna bake this in a preheated 425 degree oven for 15 minutes. Okay, after it's nice and hot, we're gonna go ahead and reduce the temperature to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and bake it for an additional 35 to 45 minutes. And at this point, I like to tent the edges with some aluminum foil to prevent the edges of the pie crust from getting too dark. And just go ahead and bake this until the crust is beautifully golden, the apples are tender, and that filling is nice and bubbly. How beautiful did this turn out, you guys? This is not the most gorgeous pie you've ever seen. I think this has gotta be my favorite pie decoration from all of Pie Week. I was so nervous putting this into the oven. I didn't know if the roses would hold their shape or not, but they turned out so beautiful. You've gotta try this. All right, now you're gonna let the pie cool for at least 3 hours. I like to cool it overnight so you get a really thick filling that's set nicely. All right, the best part, let's dig in. And if you guys give this a try, be sure to tag me in a picture on social media. I'd love to see how your pie crust designs turned out, or share this video with somebody who you know would totally love to give this a try. All right, I wanna get the rose right in the slice. Is this not the most beautiful slice of apple pie you've ever seen? Then just add a scoop of vanilla ice cream. Okay, let's get a bite. I wanna get all the apples. Guys, that apple pie filling is like buttery, brown, sugary deliciousness. The apples are nice and crisp and tart and juicy. This pie is out of this world. And if you guys love this recipe, you're gonna love the rest of my Pie Week videos, so be sure to check those out too. And the best part is you can make the crust and the filling ahead of time, and then just go ahead and put it all together, pop it in the oven when you're ready to serve it for a great make-ahead recipe. So there you have my favorite apple pie. Thanks so much for watching and leaving me comments. You guys are the best. I love you so much. Don't forget to subscribe for tons more videos that I know you're gonna love, and I'll see you right here next time. Bye, guys.
All right, guys, day 5 of Pie Week on my YouTube channel. Today we're doing good old-fashioned apple pie. This is my mom's favorite. It's so good. But can we talk about these decorations? I'm showing you guys how to make these beautiful pie crust roses to decorate with. How gorgeous.